Now, let's go to the construction of a bar chart. And to do that, we have been given a data, been given a set of data, yeah? And from our example two, we can see that our data says the table shows the number of cars of different makes in a car park, illustrates this data on a bar chart. So what is most important to us is the data that is there, the make. We have the make of different cars, Fiat, Renault, Leyland, Rolls-Royce, Ford, and Datsun. And this is what is important for us. So let me just cut off the tip and take this one, this data off. Okay. So now we have our data like this. We need to plot a bar chart. The first thing we are going to do here is to draw our coordinates. We'll need two coordinates. One like a y-axis coordinate and one like an x-axis coordinate. So in this case, I think it doesn't matter how we place it anyway, but as a matter of ease, it will be easier for you to put the number on your y coordinate and put the make on your x coordinate, just for ease of construction. Anyhow you put the coordinate does not really matter. So now let us draw our line for our y axis, okay? Our y coordinate, which is in this case going to be for the number, and then for our x coordinate, another line, we'll draw another line which is going to be for our make. So we can label that now. The x coordinate is make, and we can label the y coordinate to be number. Remember, labeling is also as important as plotting your graphs. Labeling is also as important as plotting your graph, so that anybody that looks at the graph knows exactly what that graph is saying. Anyone could just draw any graph and the message is not passed across. So the labeling is a vital part of your graph plotting. Okay, now that we've got that out of the way, let us go ahead and plot our graph. In plotting our graph, now that I've put all this one, let us still go ahead with labeling to put some marks to make our graph plotting easy. So I'll just draw those tiny lines, just a kind of markers. I'll draw the markers. We could see that they have been spaced equal distances apart. Okay, so then now that I've done that, before I go ahead and then start labeling this particular or start grading this my y-axis, the one thing for me to do is to first of all look at the range of my data. I can see that the highest number we have there is Ford, which is 42, and then the least we have there is Rolls-Royce. Now this is also an important aspect of plotting your graph: choosing the right gradation to use for your axis. Choosing the right gradation to use for your axis. And some numbers that are advisable to use when you are plotting your graphs include 2, 4, 5, 10, and the multiples. Please don't use number 3. Don't use 3 and multiples of 3. 3, 9, please don't use them. 6, don't use those numbers. Use this for ease of plotting. Use numbers like 2, 4, 5, 10, and some of their multiples. So in this case now, we are looking at our highest being 42 and our least being 5. Least being 5, highest being 42. So for space, we have 4 gradations. So we are going to be labeling this in spaces of 10. If we use 10, it will still fall in within this range of our vertical axis. So we'll put that 10, we'll use 20, then we'll use 30, and then we'll use 40. Are we following so far? Okay, so we also, now that we've done that, we can go ahead and plot. Move ahead and plot. So the first thing we'll do is to take our ruler. You take your ruler, and then when you take your ruler, you come to the first one, which is Fiat. So based on, we have that Fiat has 14 people, 14 cars. We have 14 cars on that Fiat. So we'll take our ruler, mark the space where there is 14. Normally, your graphs will be graded in spaces of 5. So based on this, you move your ruler to where 14 is, between 10 and 20. Half of that gap is 15. So just below 15 is where we have 14. So we rule a faint construction line to the horizontal, parallel to our horizontal axis. That's the make axis, parallel to a very straight line. And then where we are comfortable to draw our bar, we'll stop there. And then we'll take from the horizontal, from the make axis, we rule a straight line parallel to the number axis. Rule a straight line. Can we see that? It's a rule. I rule a straight line parallel to the number axis to meet this your construction line. Could you see? Can you see that? Good. If you have followed that, we'll go next to the next step. We can now draw our horizontal bar on based on what we've drawn here, based on the width of the bar you want to use. So I'll draw my horizontal. And then from that horizontal should be parallel to the horizontal, that's the to the make. This line is parallel. You can see that it is very straight as the make. They are both parallel. Can you see that? This line we've just drawn now is parallel to your make axis. Then from there, we can draw another vertical line parallel to the number axis to meet the make axis. That is it. Could you see that? Very easy. Very easy. Okay. Now, the next thing we have Reynolds. We have 23 people, 23 cars, sorry, 23 cars under Reynolds. So what we'll do, you can see that between 20 and 30, we have 25. That's the midway point between 20 and 30. Midway point. Do we get that? Midway point of 20 and 30 is 25. So just below 25, we have 23. Just below 25, we have 23. So what we are going to do there is to rule our horizontal line parallel to the make axis. We rule under a horizontal line parallel to the make axis. Can you see that? Faint. Please let your construction lines be different from your main lines. You can see you can see my construction line there. It's light blue, very faint. Parallel to my make axis. Then where I want to draw my bar, I draw when I get to where I want to draw my bar. I draw, I take my ruler, make my ruler to be parallel to my number axis, and then rule a line. Can you see that? Very beautiful. You ruled your line. Now that I've got this one, I take my ruler again, make to the number axis, and then draw the second line for my bar, and then I could cover that up. Can you see that? Very easy. Remember, the width of the bars is not what is most important. What is most important is the length of the bar. But as a matter of aesthetics, and it's a matter of making your work neat, it is good to keep your bars within measurement of equality. You can see that all my bars are having equal width. I'm not saying that because of the width is not important, I should draw them at whatever spacing I want to. No, look at the width of my bars are equal. Do we get that? Okay. So the next one is Leyland. Leyland has 39 cars. I mean 37 cars, sorry. So between 40 and 30 we have 35. Midpoint between 30 and 40 we have 35. So half above, just above 35, we now rule a line for 37. Take our ruler, make it parallel to the make axis, and then rule a horizontal line to where we want to draw our bar. So when we get to that place, we'll take our ruler again, place it to be vertical to the number, place it to be vertical to the number axis, and then rule a line. Can you see that? Are you following so far? Okay. So now that we've done that, I go to the place where I want to draw this one, draw the other side of the bar, and I draw based on the width of the bar, I've drawn this line. Then after that, I can cover it up. Are you following so far? Good. So now we have, the next one is Rolls Royce, which is about the list card that we have there. Rolls Royce is the next one. Okay, I can label that. Okay, Leyland now. So let me go to Rolls Royce. For the Rolls Royce, we have five cards. So I take my ruler to the five number mark, make it horizontal to the make axis. Five is between 10 and 0. So that is midpoint. I rule a line horizontal parallel to the make axis. And where I want to draw, when I get to the place I want to draw my bar, I can then draw my vertical bar parallel to the number axis. Can you see that? And then I draw the second bar, the second vertical bar, and then cover it up. So easy so far. Okay, then we have to label that. That is a Rolls Royce. Okay, then we have the next one, Ford. Ford is the highest number we have there, 42. So if we go to the vertical bar, we have 40 as the position we have there that we've labeled there. So slightly above 40, we have 42. Slightly above 40, we have 42. So I'll rule a horizontal line parallel to my make axis. Can you see that? A faint construction line. And where I get to the point where I want to draw my bar, I can now take my ruler, keep it straight and parallel to the number axis, and then rule that line. Go to the second side where I have my width, the width of my bar, and then rule it up. Can you see that? And then I can cover that. Then the label for that is Ford. Okay, so the next one we have is Dasun. Can you see the way I'm taking my time to label as I'm progressing, label each of the steps? Okay, we have Dasun. And for Dasun, we have 18 cars. 18 is between 20 and 10. Slightly below 20, we have 18. So I take my ruler close to where we have 20, and then let my ruler be parallel to the make axis, straight and parallel to the make axis, and then I rule that line to where I want to draw my bar. When I get to the place I'm to draw my bar, I can now draw the vertical bar, keeping my ruler straight to the number axis. I draw this first bar, right? Then I draw the second bar by the width. I draw the top of the bar, and then I can draw the second vertical bar. And QED. The next thing I do is to label that, and I have that soon. So that is just an easy step to construct your bar chart. So please, I would like us to do some work examples, and if you have some other ones that you want us to handle together, do well to leave it in the comment section. Thank you for your time, and please do subscribe. Goodbye. Have a nice day.